In my previous videos, there is a very profound statement I made regarding what you must look out for before taking readings on a vernier calipers.
Then now, before measuring, you're supposed to ensure that the calipers read zero when fully closed. Now, these are the calipers. Let's fully close them. When we fully close them and you bring closer, you're supposed to ensure that the first line on the vernier scale is supposed to be coinciding with the zero mark on the main scale when the thing is fully closed. Right there, it is fully closed.
That was the condition I set when I was doing my previous videos. When the jaws are fully closed, the initial readings on the vernier must coincide with the zero mark on the main scale. However, this may not always be the case. Sometimes during the process of handling the vernier calipers, these vernier calipers are instruments that could get knocks, they could get mechanical shocks, and this might alter this condition, this initial condition of the zero mark on the main scale coinciding with the first graduation on the vernier scale. Now, if you may look, these jaws, the jaws of this vernier caliper are fully closed. But if you will look closely, if your eyesight is sharp, that is, if you may look closely, the zero mark on the main scale is not exactly coinciding with the first graduation on the vernier scale. Let's look at this other one. It's the same here. When these jaws are fully closed, you may realize that the zero mark on the main scale is not coinciding with the first graduation on the vernier scale. From my previous videos, when the jaws were fully closed, you saw that the initial mark on the vernier scale coincided with the zero mark on the main scale. But when looking closely at these vernier calipers, when the jaws are fully closed, the two marks do not coincide. This means that the vernier calipers are registering a reading when it's not supposed to be doing so. And this simply means that when eventually you take a reading, the reading that you will take will have an error in it. So for us to be able to get accurate readings, we need to remove this error. Now, when we close the jaws of a vernier caliper and realize that the vernier caliper is giving a reading, it means that the vernier caliper has gotten an error. This kind of error is what we call the zero error. By definition, the zero error is the condition whereby a measuring instrument, such as a vernier caliper, it could be a micrometer screw gauge, it could be any other measuring instrument, registers a reading when there should not be any reading. In this video, I'll demonstrate how to accommodate the zero error when taking readings on a vernier caliper, coming up. Ding, 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 ding. When it comes to vernier calipers, there are two types of errors, the positive error and the negative error. The positive zero error refers to the case when the jaws of the calipers are fully closed and are reading the positive reading. For example, this is our main scale and this is our vernier scale. And now when the scale is fully closed, that is at zero, you find that this graduation is supposed to be coinciding with that one, but instead there is a gap in the positive direction. So when the gap is in the positive direction, we consider that to be a positive zero error. Likewise, when we are talking about the negative zero error, it is when the reading is negative when the jaws are fully closed. This is how it looks like. This is the initial mark. Here, this part of the diagram, this is representing when the jaws are fully closed. So now when the jaws are fully closed and the zero mark is not coinciding with the first graduation of the vernier caliper, but it is such that the first graduation of the vernier calipers is in the negative direction from the zero mark. It's in the negative direction. So it means that whenever we detect that there is a zero error, we are supposed to first find that error. Then when we find the error, we go ahead and take the correct reading. Now when we take the reading, we know that in that reading, there is an error in it. So after getting the reading, we take away the error so that we get the accurate reading. This is what we are going to do now. Now, before we take the reading, let's look at when the jaws are fully closed. When the jaws are fully closed, this is the zero error. It is such that this graduation is not coinciding with that one. So when they are not, so we need to first find the zero error. So we, of course, we are going to first take the main scale reading. Of course, the main scale reading is going to be 0.00 because it is 0.00. Then the vernier scale reading is going to give us, now of course the vernier scale gives us to the second place of decimal, or we multiply it by 0.01, which is the least count. So it's going to become 1, this is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Now it is the fourth graduation that is coinciding with a markup. So it means that it's going to be 0.04. So when you add the two, it's going to become 0.04. So it means that this 0.04 centimeters, this is our zero error, and it's in the positive direction. So this is positive 0.04. Now let's take the correct reading. So in taking the correct reading, so we shall still main scale. Like I said earlier, it's going to be 9.1. So 9.1 something. So it's going to be 9.10 centimeter. Then from here, we are going to count up to where the first, this is 0, 1, 2, 3. It is the third stick or the third graduation that is first coinciding with the upper, the upper graduation. So it's going to be 3. So it means that the vernier scale is going to be 0.03 centimeters. Now it is 0.03 centimeters because the vernier scale gives us to the second place of decimal. Or it is, you count 0, 1, 2, 3 and you multiply it by the least count, and of which in this case the least count is 0.01. When you add the two, you get 9.13 centimeters. But now this 9.13 centimeters that we have gotten here as the correct reading is having this error in it. So it means for us to get the accurate reading of this vernier caliper, we need to take away this error, because when these two jaws were fully closed, this vernier caliper was giving a reading of 0.04. So we need to remove it so that we're able to get the accurate reading. So for positive zero errors, definitely we're going to say it's going to be 9.13 minus this error so that we get the actual reading. So the correct reading will be 9.13 minus 0.04. And that is going to give us, whenever we are having a positive zero error, we simply subtract that error from the final reading we will have gotten, and we get the correct reading. So this is the vernier caliper. Jaws are fully closed. When the jaws are fully closed, it is registering a reading at the point when it's not supposed to. So it means that this vernier caliper is having a zero error. Zero error. It is a main scale. Of course, the main scale reading will always be 0.00. Then the vernier scale reading is going to be, we have, this is 0, 1, 2, 3. So it is the third graduation on the vernier scale that is the first one to coincide with the graduation in the main scale. So this is going to become 3 times 0.01, because the vernier scale gives us to the second place of decimal, it becomes 0.03. And definitely 0.03 centimeters. That is our zero error. So now after getting our zero error, we go ahead and get the correct reading now. So to get the reading here, of course, the main scale reading is going to become 8.1.2.3. So that is going to be 8.30 centimeters. Then now we go ahead and read the vernier scale. The vernier scale, we start from the first graduation, is going to be 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. It is the sixth one that is coinciding with a mark in the main scale. So now that we've gotten the sixth one, it's the sixth one, times 0.01, it becomes 0.06 centimeters. This is the vernier scale reading, and when we add the two, it becomes 8.36 centimeters. Now again, this 8.36 centimeters has got an error in it of 0.03, so we need to remove this error from this to get the correct reading. So to the correct reading will become 8.36 minus 0.03, and that is going to give us 8.33 centimeters. Now that is how we deal with the zero error when it is positive. This is a positive zero error. It's a positive zero error because the first graduation of the vernier scale is in front of the zero mark. Now with the negative zero error, the first graduation of the vernier scale vernier scale is always behind the zero mark. Now with this one, we are going to count it a bit differently. When we were looking at the positive zero error, we were counting from here. 0, 1, 2, 3. But now when it comes to the negative zero error, we are going to count from backwards to up to the point where the first graduation in the vernier scale coincides with a graduation in the main scale. So in this case, this is how we are going to do it. To get our zero error first, of course the main scale is always going to be, main scale reading is going to always be 0.00. Then the vernier scale reading, now this is a counting from the back. If you look through here, this is the point where the graduations are coinciding with the main scale. So it means that instead of counting from here to come up to that, we are going to count from this way backwards. So in this case, it's going to be 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. It's the sixth one that is coinciding. So the vernier scale here, it's going to be 0.06, which is that. So that is a negative error, negative 0.06 centimeters. So now to go ahead and find the correct reading of this, this is going to become 5.1.2. So the main scale reading is 5.20 centimeters. Then the vernier scale reading is going to become, this is of course 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, the fifth. So it's going to give us the second place of decimal, that is 5 times 0.01. It's going to be 0.05 centimeters. So this is going to become 5.25. I mean, this is the reading of the of this vernier scale, but remember, when this thing had been fully closed, it was having reading negative 0.06. So it means that to get the correct reading of this, it means we are supposed to get 5.25 and add this. So in this case, we're going to get the reading we've gotten here and we subtract the zero error still. So in this case, it's going to become 5.25 centimeters subtract the zero error. The zero error here is negative, so it's minus negative 0.06. So definitely you end up finding yourself adding the two. It's going to become 5.25 negative, that is plus 0.06. And your answer will be 5.31. Let's do the second example. So likewise here, the zero error is in the negative side. So it means the vernier scale, of course it's 0.01. Then we have, I mean, this is the main scale. Then the vernier scale, because it is in the negative direction, the first graduation that is coinciding with the graduations that are coinciding are right there. Because it's a negative zero error, we're going to count from the back. So this is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So it's going to become 0.07. This is going to be 0.00. So when we add the two, it is 0.07. That is the zero error. But this is a negative zero error because it is in the negative direction. Then we go ahead and make our reading. This is going to be 7.1. So it's going to, the main scale reading is 7.10. centimeters. Then the vernier scale reading is going to be 0, 1, 2, 3. It's the third line that is coinciding with the line in the main scale, so it's going to be 0.03. we get that 3 and multiply it by 0.01. that's the vernier scale reading, and when we add the two, it becomes 7.13 centimeters. Now to get the real exact reading, the one that is accurate, it is going to be the reading we've gotten, the one we've observed, which is 7.13 centimeters, subtract the zero error. And in this case, the zero error is a negative, which is negative 0.07 centimeters. And you'll end up with 7.13, negative and negative will become plus 0.07. And when you add the two, you end up with, in a nutshell, when we are taking our readings and the vernier calipers we were using has had a positive zero error, when we get our final reading, all we have to do to that positive zero error is to subtract it off from the reading. And this is what we did here. But if the zero error is a negative one, we do the reverse. And by doing the reverse, I mean that if we're having a negative zero error, when we get our final reading, we simply just have to add the zero error, and that is what is being done here. But for purposes of making everything uniform, this is what you can adopt. For purposes of being uniform in terms of what formula you should use, to get the correct reading, we say it is going to be equal to the observed reading. The observed reading is the reading that you read before considering the zero error. So it's the observed reading minus the zero error. Now, if the zero error is positive, you'll put the positive number here. If the zero error is a negative, it's going to be minus negative the zero error. And of course, the negative and the negatives will always cancel out and becomes a positive. And you'll find yourself adding like we've been doing here. This brings us to the end of this video. Thanks for watching. Feel free to check out other excellent videos on the channel and don't forget to subscribe. For Kisembo Academy, this is Arnold Rangakuramia helping you manifest excellence.